I was at a crossroad. I could continue down this comfortable, endless path just like everybody else, looking forward to the next raise, the next promotion, and the next so-called feeling of success. Or I could ditch the comfortable life and seek to live a life full of purpose and meaning. The financial wealth may not be as abundant down this path, but the time would be. Time to make a change in people's lives, time to spend with my friends and family, and time to actually live. I knew at that moment, if I didn't change my path right now, it'll be this way for the rest of my life. All right, so today is March 1st, 2021, and I'm about to voluntarily quit my job. And I'll be honest with you, I've never been this nervous, but this excited at the same time because, you know, deep down, I know this is what I want. I like to think that I've always had it figured out, but in all honesty, I never did. I remember researching online my junior year of high school, searching for majors to study in college, and instead of asking myself what I actually wanted to do, I was so focused on finding a major that would set me up the best out of school and would make me the most amount of money. I am sure you can relate to this, and it seems like money always finds a way to cloud our judgment even in the most critical of times. So with money at the forefront of my mind, I went to school for mechanical engineering, and after 4 years, I graduated with my degree with a job lined up. And as naive and ambitious as I was as a young adult at the time, I was ready to quote unquote make money. After graduation in 2017, I began working for a major oil and gas company here in Houston, Texas, and I must say that I was compensated extremely well for someone right out of school. My job was exciting, it was fast-paced, and the people that I worked with, they were just as great. However, my motivation at the time was to make as much money as I could, regardless of the type of job that I was having or the fulfillment that I gained from it. And this was the element that I was the most excited about, the first big paycheck. I remember getting that first paycheck, I even woke up at 2 a.m. just to see it actually hit my bank account, and instead of feeling this overwhelming rush of excitement, I felt empty inside. Seriously, there was not even 1 ounce of excitement, and all I could do is stare at my phone in my bed and look at those digits and feel nothing. I was so confused. This is what I've been working so hard for since junior year of high school, and now that it's finally here, I'm empty inside? Where did I go wrong? And I'm sure that many of you can actually relate to this story, you know, working extremely hard for something, regardless if it's for a job or a goal that you set for yourself individually. And then once you get there, once you achieve that goal, you feel that instant gratification, but just as quickly as it came, it quickly phases out. Then you're just left there, you know, you're left there in the same place that you previously were. You're either just as happy as before, or possibly even unhappier. This is known as the arrival fallacy. A term coined by psychology expert Dr. Tao Ben-Shahao, meaning the illusion that once we make it, and once we attain our goal or reach our destination, we will reach lasting happiness, which isn't always the case. Sometimes when reaching these goals or even these heights, it may not necessarily deliver the happiness that we were expecting. So the question is, why does this happen? Why when we finish college and we get our first job, is it not enough? Why when making a six-figure income, it's not enough? Why do we constantly have these moments in our life where we get to the mountaintop and then we're suddenly back in the valley? What I took away from this moment is that it's never going to be enough. You know, that imaginary ceiling, that boundary that we put for ourselves, it's never going to actually meet our lasting happiness that we're expecting. And the only way to prevent this is to stop predicting it. What we need to do is we need to quit mapping out our every move, what is going to make us happy, and seek goals that will truly bring us happiness, like relationships and meaningful work. You know, we weren't put on this earth to chase money and paychecks. At that very moment, lying in my bed at 2 a.m., looking at those digits, I knew this was not the life that I wanted to live. I told myself that my life was going to be filled with purpose and it was going to be filled with time, and I wasn't going to exchange my valuable time just for a paycheck, just for a couple digits on a screen. I was still just as driven, if not more than before, but I wanted to build something for my career because I wanted to, not because I had to. I was not going to be focused on chasing money and corporate success. The week following that moment, I began reading books on self-development and researched online for how I was going to do all of this. Now, I knew what I wanted my life to look like, but I was unsure financially how I was going to make it all work. Book after book and YouTube videos after YouTube videos, and I mean an endless amount of YouTube videos trying to self-educate myself, it wasn't until later that year until I finally found what I was looking for. That was when I discovered the FIRE movement, or financial independence, retire early. It's a relatively new lifestyle movement with the goal of gaining financial independence and retiring early, typically in your 30s or your early 40s. You live frugally in your 20s, you pay off debts, and you aggressively save the majority of your income. And I'm talking 50, 60, 70% of your income is going straight to savings and investing for that time when you're ready to retire. Eventually, you'll gather enough money to invest a large sum, and you can live off of your assets and your returns year over year. So at this moment, I took out a pencil and a piece of paper so I could create my plan. The one thing that I didn't like about the FIRE movement was that you had to live 10, 15, even 20 years as frugally as possible so you could aggressively save up. And in my 20s, being a young adult, I did not want to sacrifice that. So instead, I took a different route. What I chose to do was to produce supplemental income through side hustles in order to accelerate my FIRE movement. At this point, it was 2018, and the first thing that I looked into was doing real estate and property management, a classic investment choice, right? So the problem was, I didn't have any capital, and I still had a good amount of student loan debt. In order to live solely off of my real estate investments, I had to own a crazy number like 25 to 30 rental properties by the time that I hit 35. And the more that I looked at this plan, I realized that I needed other supplemental income in addition to my rental properties to even have a chance of making this work. Because remember, I barely had any capital to start out with, and most importantly, I was in a lot of debt. Later that year, and with a little bit of success in my pocket, I started another side hustle called Rhodes Advertising, in which I would advertise local businesses in Ubers using iPads. Now at first, the business was a huge success, but it quickly got trampled when I got a call from a local competitor. With this much larger competitor entering the Houston market, I really only had one option, and that was to sell my book of business and call it a wrap. Don't get me wrong, I learned a lot from this opportunity, and I knew it would set me up for the next one. After all, it was my first side hustle that made me some money. Fast forward to 2019, I had barely made any progress, at least in my own mind, and I was so discouraged at this point if I could actually make it work by the time that I hit 30. Then, it all changed. In May 2019, I finally found my first true side hustle that consistently profited, which was purchasing a Polaris Slingshot and renting it out on Turo. I would rent this vehicle out for about $150 a day since it was considered an exotic vehicle, and my loan and insurance payment, my expenses, were only $320 a month. So as long as I rented this out three times a month, I would profit. There was even one month where I was able to pay for the mortgage of my property with the money that I made from renting out my Slingshot. This started to inspire me and gave me the confidence that, hey, I can do this. After starting that side hustle, I was a genuinely happier person, and I finally saw a glimmer of hope at the end of that tunnel. Although this was a great start, I needed at least a couple more side hustles in order to make this work financially. I then began searching for more side hustles and found e-commerce to be an interesting industry. Specifically, I found out that people just like you and me are actually using Amazon to resell generic products, and they're making it a full-time business. You could live anywhere in the world, you would never have to see your products, and you could let Amazon do all the hard work once you got your system in place. I was immediately intrigued by this because it aligns so well with my value of creating time wealth. A couple months later, I had my FBA business up and running. I was selling everything from Bluetooth headphones, workout resistance bands, all the way to clothing and hats. The possibilities were endless, and all I had to do, find the product, have my supplier ship it to Amazon, and then I'd watch the sales come in. So later in 2020, I began my YouTube channel centralized around selling on Amazon, Amazon FBA, and side hustles so I could teach others like you how to do all of this. This may come to you as a surprise, but my intention was actually never to turn this channel into a true side hustle. My goal was to share my story, and most importantly, my goal was to help people like you gain financial freedom through side hustles. They say that success is not the result of making money. Earning money is the result of success, and success is in direct proportion to our service. Starting in 2021, I had finally turned all of my side hustles into enough monthly income to support my lifestyle as is, and that's when I chose voluntarily to quit my full-time job and to do what I love. Now, it's going to be tough, and you're going to have to leave your comfort zone in order to attain what you truly want. There were so many times that I was filled with so much self-doubt, and I'd question myself, is this what I truly wanted? And I'd also ask, you know, I went to college for 4 years just to throw that degree away. Despite all of these negative emotions, I want to let you know that you can get through it, as long as you know your why. Your why is the reason why you get out of bed each morning, the reason why you're excited about life, and the reason you have purpose. My previous so-called why used to be about making as much money as I could, and I know to this day that was never my why. My why has always been focused on living an intentional life with an abundance of time to spend with my friends and my family. Looking back at my experience, I don't want to give you the false perception that I knew exactly what I was doing, because in all honesty, I really didn't. I started at zero just like you. I had zero supplemental income, zero subscribers on my YouTube channel, and zero reviews on all of my Amazon products. Everybody starts at zero, but understanding what truly drives you, what truly motivates you, is going to help you find that final destination and define what you're looking for in life. The last message that I want to leave you with is a quote by Mark Twain that I found extremely powerful in the midst of all this. 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did do. So throw off the bowlines, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails. Explore, dream, discover. You are the author of the book of your life, so make it one worth reading.